dear students, a very warm welcome to you all. In previous video, we have discussed about some of the models. So let us continue with other models or model verbs. So today we will discuss about will, would, ought to, dare and need. We'll discuss these models today. Let's start with will. Whenever you are certain about something, whatever you are going to do, if you are certain, use will. So there is a force in will. Certainty, surety. So if you are certain about what you are going to do, use will. Okay. So will is used for future, to talk about future. For example, I will be late to the meeting. I will be late to the meeting tomorrow. So to talk about future, when you are certain, use will. Next is to make a request. Will you help me with my homework? So to make a request also we use will. Next, to show willingness. For example, I'll give you a ride home. It means I'm willing to give you a ride home. To show the willingness. Next is refusal. To refuse something. So that is the negative form. My mom won't let me go to the party. Won't means will not. Will not short form is won't. So my mom won't let me go to the party. It means the mom will not let me go to the party. Next, in conditional clause also we use will. For example, if it rains, I will bring an umbrella. So only if it rains, then I will bring umbrella, otherwise I won't, okay? Next model is would. Would indicates willingness, habitual actions in the past, wishes, desire, polite request and probability. Let us see with examples. Request. So would is more polite than will. Would you lend me a pen, please? So you are making a polite request. Would you lend me a pen, please? Next is offer. When you offer something, I would be happy to help you with your homework. Means you are offering him help. Next, it is also used in conditional clause. For example, if we had a car, we would drive for work. So there is a condition, if we had a car, we would drive for work. Next is habit in the past. To talk about the habit in the past. For example, when I was at school, I would get up before everyone else in the house. So this is the past habit when I was in school. Okay. It indicates past habit. So for these things we use would. Next is ought to. Ought to is equal to should, but it is less frequently used than should. Ought to means should. So that much only force it has. But it is less frequently used. Most of the time we use should. For ought to is used to give advice. You ought to revise your lessons. Or you should revise your lessons. So ought to is similar to should. Ought to is similar to should. Next, probability or certainty. Our team ought to win this match today. Our team should win this match today. Okay. Now generally, ought to is not used with questions or negative sentences. We don't use ought to in forming a question or in making a negative sentence. Okay. So next, number 11 model is dare. So dare means to show that someone is not afraid of anything. Means someone has the daring, is not afraid of anything. Yes. Dare is used as a main verb and it is followed by the infinitive to in the affirmative sentence. And in the interrogative and negative, infinitive to is optional. You may use or you may not use. Okay. For example, he is a man who dares to fight for his rights. Here, dare is used as a main verb along with the infinitive to, as it is affirmative sentence. Next, he doesn't dare ask for more money. So here to is optional. You may or may not use it. It is a negative sentence. So in negative sentence, infinitive to is optional. Next, do you dare be honest with him? This is an interrogative sentence. So here also to is optional. Okay. Next, the last model is need. Now, like an ordinary verb, need to is a softer alternative to must or have to. So instead of using must or have to, we can use need to. Need to is a more softer. It is softer alternative for must or have to. Okay. Now need indicates necessity. There is a necessity of something. So we use need. For example, I need to finish it tonight. I have a deadline tomorrow. So I need to finish today. I have a deadline tomorrow. So there is a need to finish it today itself because tomorrow is the deadline. Okay. Next example, I don't need to finish it tonight. This is a negative sentence. There is no need. There is a lack of need. That is negative. Okay. Next, does she need to do it? This is an interrogative sentence. I hope you have understood model verbs or model auxiliaries or simply models. Okay. Till then, stay safe. Be at home. Thank you.